Hi everyone, I'm Annie McKee and I'm here in Boston with Kurt Nikisch and the team at HBR Live, and I'm really excited to talk with you about happiness at work, why it matters so much, and what you can do to be happier on the job. Thank you all for coming today, for visiting Facebook, and for getting ready to ask some great questions. Kurt's going to help me ask questions throughout my talk and at the end, so don't hesitate, just jump right in. So why does happiness at work matter so much? I think the answer to that is obvious. We all care about what we do. We want to love our jobs. We want to get up in the morning and be excited. Work is where we learn. Work is where we grow. Work is where we achieve our goals, our professional goals. And when that's lacking, any of that is lacking, we can find ourselves really unhappy in the rest of our lives. So the first reason that work is so important to us and that happiness matters so much is because if we're unhappy at work, we're unhappy in life. The other reason it matters is because we spend so much time working. We carry our work in our pockets, those digital devices that we carry everywhere. They're constantly demanding us to look, write, talk, work all the time. And if we are going to work that much, we've got to guarantee that we're not miserable. It's a must. I'll talk about it in a minute, too, about why we have to watch out for those digital devices and why they can really get in the way of happiness as well. Third reason that work is so important to us and happiness matters so much is that it can be a ballast that helps us deal with the occasional low points in our lives. We all have them, times when maybe somebody's sick or you've got a problem that you need to deal with in a relationship or something like that. When that happens and when we can go to work and just throw ourselves into a project, that feels so good and it gives us the resilience to deal with some of the problems that we all have in our lives. So happiness at work matters a lot. It's where we learn and grow, it's where we spend a lot of time, and happiness really allows us to feel good in our lives when we feel good at work. So what is happiness at work? Is it just feeling good? Is it just kind of an emotional experience? Is it just pleasure? It's actually more than that. In my work and studies around the world with leaders just like you, with managers just like you, and with employees just like you, I ask the question, what do you need in order to be fulfilled? What do you need to be your best at work? And the answers I got back in thousands of interviews that I and my team did in countries as far away as South Africa, Asia, the United States, and Europe, really came down to a couple of things. I want to know that my work has meaning, that what I do day to day makes a difference, that I'm having impact. So the first part of my definition of happiness at work is purpose. We need to feel that our work has purpose. Another thing that people told us is that we need to feel hopeful and optimistic, and that the work we're doing and the job we have is helping us reach for a future that is personally meaningful. You know, sometimes we make the mistake of thinking that a vision of the future that our organization gives us is enough. It's actually not. The vision that we need to fuel hope has to be a personal vision, hopefully incorporating where your organization is going. So if you want to be happy at work, in addition to purpose, you need to feel hopeful. And to feel hopeful, you've got to have a personal vision that allows you to think about what you're learning, where you're going in your job now, and where you hope to be in the future. So purpose and hope. The third part of my definition of happiness at work is around friendship. There's this old myth that says you can't be friends with the people you work with. That's nonsense. Of course we have friends in the workplace. Of course we need friends in the workplace. We need people to share stories with, to talk with. We need to feel that we belong to a group, a tribe. Really feels like our people, people we share values with, people we share goals with, people we can collaborate with. Now, mind you, we're all very different from one another, especially in today's global, diverse workplace. That's really important, but we've got to find those common bonds that make us feel that we're in it together. And you know what else? We need to feel that we are cared for and that we can return care and generosity and gratitude to the people that we're with. So the definition of happiness at work is a feeling of purpose and having impact, a sense of hope and optimism about the future, and having friends in the workplace. That's my definition of happiness at work. So if you want to be happier at work, maybe it's not perfect. Maybe you've been thinking about what you could do. It's the new year after all. We've all made some resolutions. Maybe you're trying hard to feel a little bit more fulfilled in your job. Or maybe you've been asking some questions about your workplace and about what you're doing and about where you're going. What can you do? So here's a little secret. Happiness is a choice. Happiness is a choice. It starts from within us. It's really easy to blame others. That boss, or that colleague we don't like, or that group that we have to spend time with at meetings every week that feel a little bit tedious and they kind of bore us a little bit. It's really easy to point fingers at all of the above, and yet that's not going to help us be happy. Happiness is not going to come from the outside. Now, mind you, there are bad bosses, and there are boring colleagues, and there are annoying people in the workplace. That's true, and we've got to learn how to deal with them. But if you want to actively move toward happiness at work, you've got to find ways to take responsibility for your own emotional experience in the workplace, for how you deal with things, and for what you do. All of us can look for ways to have more impact on the job. Look around. What can you fix? Look around for an opportunity to create something new. Look around for an opportunity to jump into a new project that gives you a chance to learn and grow. That will give you more of a sense of purpose. It will make work more meaningful. And if you want to be more hopeful on the job, let's go back to that personal vision I was talking about a few minutes ago. You actually need to think about 5 years out in all aspects of your life, your personal life, your relationships outside of work, what you want to learn, the things you care about, and literally write it down. Where do you want to be? Where are you going? How does your job today fit in with that vision? And what can you do now to ensure that you're moving toward that vision, that very personal vision of your life and your work? It's really important to take responsibility for that too. Just the act of writing a personal vision will make you feel more optimistic and happier in the workplace. And finally, make a friend. Make a friend. Find somebody who's kind of interesting to you. Different, maybe the same as you, but somebody who intrigues you. Get to know them. Go out of your way. Be the first one to be generous. Be the first one to trust. Be the first one to give. Find time to spend with a couple of people at work. And, you know, like me, probably many of you are introverts, and you're thinking, oh gosh, do I have to go out to dinner with everybody, or do I have to party after work, or do I have to go on vacations with these people? And the answer to that is no, you don't. But we do need to devote time to our relationships. In our work looking at emotional intelligence in the workplace, which as you know is critical for success, what we've found is that emotionally intelligent people build resonant relationships, resonant friendships, relationships that feel good and allow us to get things done. If you want to be happier at work, you can do that too. So as you plan to be happier in the workplace, get concrete about it. Think about what you can do to have an impact. Think about what you can do to move toward the future, what you can learn, how you can grow. And think about what you can do to build strong, powerful, positive relationships with at least one person and hopefully more in your organization. That's what you need to do if you want to be happier at work. The last thing I want to talk about today is, how do you get out of your own way? This all sounds like common sense, and it is. It really, truly is common sense. But a lot of times we find that we actually get in our own way. And again, back to the many people that we talk with over the course of a number of years, I ask folks, what inhibits your effectiveness?